Hello everyone. In this video, we'll be creating a travel application and SAP build using ABAP. We'll use Joule for Developers capabilities and show you how they speed up the development with generative AI. I've already created a package for this project here where we will store all the artifacts. So let's get started. First, let's create a UI service along with the underlying wrap business objects using the ABAP Cloud Generator. Right-click the package and select Generate ABAP Repository Objects. Then let's select OData UI Service from scratch and click Next and Next again. Here in the Joule sidebar, type the prompt describing the basic data model for your application. Let's describe two entities, travel and booking, and tell Joule which tables they're based on. Then hit Enter. Here's the proposal Joule created, describing which entities will be created and which fields they'll contain. This all looks good, so let's hit Accept. Now we need to add two additional fields to the entities, destination and discounted flight price, so we'll tell Joule to add those as well. This list of artifacts looks good, so let's click Next. For this demo, we won't worry about the transport request, so we can just click Finish. Now all the artifacts have been generated, so let's publish and preview the app. Here it is. We have our boilerplate CRUD-compliant Fiori application and the Joule for Developers capabilities made it quick and easy. Next, we'll explore the feature Joule Code Explain. After creating our boilerplate travel application, I enhanced one of the fields in the CDS entity booking and added lines 28 through 32. The goal is to apply a discount for the flight based on the airline. Let's highlight these lines, right-click, and select Explain. Joule generates a helpful explanation of the calculation in the CDS entity. Now let's look at how to generate CDS unit tests using Joule to ensure they're all working properly. For our travel app, we want to create a test class for the booking CDS entity. Right-click the CDS entity, hover over the Joule menu, and select New ABAP Test Class. Give it a name and description, and click Next. Here, select all test cases and click Generate. This looks good, so click Next and Finish. Joule generated the test classes, so let's run it. All 9 methods we tested for passed. Next, let's explore the ABAP unit test capability. When we're testing code, sometimes we run into dependencies that make test results unpredictable, such as database calls or external APIs. A common way to handle this is by using test doubles, and Joule makes that process much easier. For setup, I've already created an ABAP helper class containing business logic that can be reused across different business objects and methods. In this example, it contains logic for validating customer IDs and translating text booking status into a status code. I've also created a blank unit test class for this helper class. Let's see how Joule identifies those test unfriendly dependencies and replaces them with test doubles. Right-click the helper class and select Start Chat for ABAP unit. Joule explains that the helper class does not contain any unit tests yet and asks how we want to proceed. Choose Find Test Unfriendly Dependencies. Here's the analysis Joule provided, showing that the helper class has one dependency, the customer data table. Joule suggests generating a test double for it, so let's click that. Joule then asks which helper class the test double should go into, and the suggestion looks good, so let's click it. Joule generates the code. There's even an option to refactor the code, but for this demo, we'll copy the generated code and replace the existing code in the test class. Finally, let's see how to add an additional unit test for our helper class using Joule Predictive Code Completion. The test we're adding is called Test Validate Customer Success, and its purpose is simple. It checks that when we pass a valid customer ID into the helper class, the validate customer method correctly returns true, ensuring the customer validation logic is working as expected. To start, let's add the method interface in the definition section of the class and then use ADT Quick Fix to generate the implementation for this method. Scroll down to the implementation section and press enter. Joule suggests the code for the test, and this is where predictive code completion helps. Instead of writing the full test logic manually, we get a ready-to-use suggestion. After reviewing the generated code, press Tab to accept it. And that brings us to the end of this demo. There's still more we could add to this application, like additional validations and determinations, but for today's purposes, we kept it simple and focused on core Joule for Developers capabilities. I hope this helped you understand how these tools can accelerate development and make your workflow more efficient. Thanks for following along.